sound you hear that lingers in you. So the first half of the play is a tragedy. Leontes, king of Sicilia, believes that his wife, Hermione, is having an affair with Polixenes, his best friend, based entirely on his own paranoia.
So I'm playing Leontes. He's a man that has a lot of emotions, happy at the beginning, but it very quickly deteriorates into just a lot of anger, a lot of jealousy, a lot of childish behaviour.
And I'm playing Hermione, Leontes' wife. Hermione is very determined, although she does get falsely accused and things play out in a pretty negative way for her. Throughout the entire play, she does keep a strong will.
I'm playing Polixenes, and Leontes is his childhood friend, and then he is accused of having an affair with his wife. He is forced to flee away as the king threatens to kill him, take his life.
The play is, in one sense, about love, but it's also really about the suffering that love can cause. When you hear the beat, you
wanna pat your feet, and you got to move. Set Sicilia in 1970s California, and David Hockney's paintings of California in that era provided a lot of reference points for the colours and the kind of things we've included in the set design. A lot of ideas also came from Sim Aaron's photography, where we have a lot of the poolside and the lovely mansions that were in California in that kind of era. It provides just a really fresh backdrop.
The tone of Sicilia, it's pretty much centralised around whatever Leontes is currently feeling at the moment, because at the start it's all happy and jolly, and then as soon as his character starts breaking down, I'm quite a cold, quite angry, quite jealous atmosphere within Sicilia.
So suddenly we're in the world of comedy, where mistaken identity, star-crossed lovers and devious rogues abound. Baby, when I met you,
there was peace. Bohemia, it's a shift from the high tragedy of Sicily in the first act. It's bold, it's big, and it's funny.
This really wanted to give off that sort of party atmosphere that you don't really feel in the first act. It's sort of meant to be this big tonal shift. You do something to me
that I can't. So I play Florizel, and he is the prince on the Bohemia side, and he is deeply in love with Bianca's character, Editha.
So she is born a princess, but given away at birth, and so she grows up in more of a lower class.
With Bohemia, we're looking 16 years later in the 1980s, and we've set it in Tennessee in the US. Bohemia is a lot more free-spirited and a lot more of a party town than Sicilia. Lots of reference points taken from Nashville's like main strip, where there's lots of like bright signs, bold colours in contrast to the very muted pastels of Sicilia. So it's quite a vibrant change.
I think it's quite nice seeing Sicilia juxtapose Bohemia's like comedy and the comic relief bit.
The way in which the comic world and the comic characters help to heal the wounds of tragedy leads to the most dazzling and audacious climax in all of Shakespeare.